Hello, and welcome back to part 12 of our Let's Play Venice. We ended last time without much success. Our war isn't going too well. I'm actually decided I'm going to see if I can actually negotiate peace with them. No, they don't want to. Okay, so we have to continue. We have the forces to achieve our goals. It's just that they're all over the place. I need to whittle down their forces and then strike out, which is a bit of a problem at the moment. So let's see here. And they have some ships here. We're not too concerned because they can't really do too much damage, I don't think. Watch me be completely wrong about that. They really want Beblos. Oh shoot. Just lost a artillery. Okay, so I'm gonna put pressure on them by attacking. This city here. And then I move my artillery or my anti-air unit here to see if I can knock out some of their bombers. This has been not a great war. I've lost a lot of units that I didn't intend to lose, so I'm having to scrape the bottom of the barrel here. Let's buy another bomber. I'm not determined to go all the way and just do much as much damage as I can against these against the Huns. Okay. So I've killed a lot of their units here already because each time you take a city, they park their units inside the city. So whenever I take the city, the unit is auto-killed, and I've killed a lot of their artillery as well. So there we go, we killed the bomber. Did they switch targets? I wonder. Yeah, they did. They're attacking this city now, but this should cover both cities. I should try to get. That was a bug. There was no Washington in this game.
Hey, mate.
Can we... Okay, so... Against my better judgment, I'm going to accept it because I think we might be in a better position if we work on rebuilding now rather than in consolidating our gains. We lost some units, but we actually gained an extra city here, and we killed a lot of their units.
Hey, mate. I put you the book. I put your car.
But at least now we sort of know. I keep forgetting to move it away from Sydney since we have no chance of. We got a golden age. We have no chance of. Taking a coup out of that. So where do I want to move this? What happened, Zurich?
Pozdrawiam cię. Mów dalej.
Maybe we have a chance. I just haven't been working on this La Venta. I'm gonna move him to La Venta because there is more of a chance. Man, that was a painful war. Did not expect it to go that badly.
Thank you.
That asshole. Only 16 people want to switch to a new ideology now, so we're in a good position. So it looks like Alexander might be trying to start a war with me, which is not good. We're not prepared for it.
The internet is the first thing that humanity made.
Okay, let's build Apollo program.
طاب يومك. هيا. مصر السخية تقدم لك هذا العرض. كلا بكل تأكيد.
Okay, we got them to declare war on Alexander, so hopefully that should take care of that for a while.
مصر السخية.
A liar, Kitchiotish.
And the Huns are out to get us, and we're number 4 on troops, so yeah, so I think the Huns are ahead of us, but behind the Greeks and the Egyptians. So we need to find a way to get some of our armies back up. We lost a lot of units in the last war. I mean, they lost more. But we don't have the cities that can build. Only, I mean, we have to spend gold basically to buy everything we need. Yeah, we're not gonna get Ur to our side. It's just a little bit of influence loss.
Jak ci się podoba moja oferta?
Yeah, there's really not much to say here. I'm just doing my turn-to-turn business. I'm thinking about what to do in terms of military. I mean, there is a social policy I'm going to unlock pretty soon. That's going to give me 6 free units, and those are going to help. But I think what we need are bombard units, naval units, and air force, which is going to cost a lot of money. And the free units from the city-states certainly help. I won't deny that. I think we got a artillery unit, which is nice. Yes, we did get an artillery unit. So this is what I'm talking about. Let's see here. Oh no, I need another, it's down here to unlock that, so trade routes, no, that's not really creative. Yeah, let's go with that. Okay. And our goal is to get to the second final bonus for freedom ideology. That lets us buy spaceship parts with gold, which is what we probably want to do because we don't really have the cities to build all the spaceship parts for us. But that also means that I need to save as much money as I can. I mean, I have a bit of money now, but... yeah, those go real fast. Good, I got another parachute trooper, which I can... drop here, let's see... No, you'll pay for this. Let's build some fighters. I'm gonna buy the hospital.
Okay. Computers up.
So, with the UN, each time you vote, the top two civs get two extra votes. So I'll get 28 the next time, and I need 44 to win. There are various paths to that. Two paths I can do is I need to liberate one of the Portuguese cities, so Lisbon is a good target, and one of the Danish cities. So these are original civs that got killed off early on. So if I were to revive them, they're going to vote for me, and their vote is 4 each. So that's 8 votes right there. So I'll go from 28 to 36. Then I'll need to find the other 8 votes, which probably is just through additional elections, which means that I think that the spaceship route might be slightly faster, but that's still a lot of spaceships to build, spaceship parts to build, and technology to research. So I'm a little bit concerned that I may not be able to hold out that long if the Huns are aggressive, and I think they are. So I think I have to be... Oh, shoot, they have artillery now. I don't like that. So I have to be building a military force as well. Yeah, and I'm like 4 techs behind the Egyptians, which isn't good. So you're going to get the spaceship parts a lot sooner than we are, because they're probably researching them right now. How soon till we get our great engineer? So about 10 turns.
Manasakatron Yaltrahma Pulsk.
That's not good. Alright, I think this is a good place to end the game. I will, after all this animation finishes, I will see you next time.